Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another exciting week of WAW Aftermath. I am your special guest commentator for the evening, the War Machine Sin. Chad Epic is off representing WAW down in Rhode Island tonight. Best of luck to him, Pyro, Falcon, and Moody Star, who are all down in Rhode Island tonight. But without further ado, we're going to start things off in the ring with Peter Labrie.
Sexy Welcome to WAW Aftermath. Tonight's opening contest is a five-person sudden death match. In-ring first from Lynn, Massachusetts, Riddles!
And for all the people back on Earth, the crew of Apollo 8 has a message that we would like to send to you.
Never go stop on this airplane by luck. Call up the haters, let's have some fun. Move to the right, swing to the left. Grab him by the neck and choke him to death. Never go stop on this airplane by luck. Call up the haters, let's have some fun. Move to the right, swing to the left. Grab him by the neck and choke him to death. I don't cut myself, but I am the hot topic. Wanna try to stop it?
Entering second from Atlanta, Georgia, Bianca Wild.
Keep holding on when my brain's ticking like a bomb. Catch the black box to come again to get me. Sweet little words, unlike nothing I have heard. Sing along, Mockingbird, yeah, don't affect me. That's right.
Entering third from Manchester, New Hampshire, Hawk.
Are you with me? Are you with me?
So it ain't no coming now.
I'll fuck you up. You can fuck me up.
Razor blades cut deep under the skin. Pass the saw, let's make it burn. Give me that blade, man, now it's my turn. Cut.
Entering fourth from Detroit, Michigan, Chris Shady.
This is what makes me. This is what I am, Bill.
QB, but I won't stop now. Real niggas, I can't stop now. Brave hearts, you hate me now. Come on,
but you ain't stop now. Ain't you too?
Cause I can't stop now.
Money I see, clothes that I buy, ice that I wear, flows that I try. Close your eyes, picture me rolling, sixes, money falling, bitches, honeys that swollen, the richest, knives get in ya. Most critically acclaimed, Pulitzer, prize winner, best storyteller, thug narrator, my style's greater, model data, big threat to a lot of you haters. Commentators, ringside, try, watching my paper, almost a decade, quite impressive, most of the best is in the S's, but it's rap shit.
Entering fifth, from Washington, D.C., Sky Nova!
I'm not in the match.
You're not in the match?
No.
Oh, what'd you hurt your neck too bad last week, sucking too much, you know what?
No. Too many chair shots, I think.
I'm thinking, Here, I'm going to figure this out for Scotty Nova because I think you messed him up a little too much the last time I was here. He's not...
medically cleared to wrestle. I don't think he's even mentally cleared to wrestle. So I think it's going to be a four-man match. I think he really knocked him for a loop, Mr. Shady. So this is going to be a four-man sudden death, right?
Yes.
Okay. Four-man sudden death. You guys rock it out. I guess I got Scotty Nova on commentary. Thanks, Shady. Oh, I guess I'm going to be joined by Scotty Nova here at the commentary table, although he doesn't look all that interested in putting on a headset. I think Scotty Nova is more interested in studying the competition for Hellbound. We've got Chris Shady and Bianca Wild as entrants in the Hellbound Championship match. And then we've got an interesting dynamic here in the ring of Hawk and Riddles, the former Inner City Posse. And it seems as though Riddles is more of the fan favorite amongst the former members of the team. When Riddles came out, there was a crowd reaction. Now the former ICP looks to be working together. But in sudden death action, a low blow is 100% legal. Bianca Wild taking early control in this sudden death match. Here to kick off things this week on Aftermath. Whoever can walk away from this match will surely gain themselves some momentum as we head closer and closer to Hellbound 2012, which is just 2 weeks away from tonight. And Bianca charges hard into the corner. Look like a modified splash. And oh, she gets taken down hard by the former five-time WAW champion and Mr. WAW himself, Chris Shady. And now he is choking Bianca Wild over the bottom rope. And the former ICP dumps Chris Shady out to the floor. Riddles and Hawk. Shady going after Hawk, pulling out the leg from underneath while Riddles takes control of Bianca Wild in the ring. That's the thing with these sudden death matches. They are fast-paced and the action is all over the place as Chris Shady goes into the brick wall. And he's taken down hard with a clothesline as Riddles gets a near fall in the ring. Here comes Hawk back into the ring. Is he going to go after his... Are they arguing about who was going to get the pin? Oh, I'm not even going to go there. The former ICP is shoving each other back and forth. It seemed the team ended peacefully, but maybe there is some leftover tension from these former tag team partners. They both turn around, block the punches from Shady and Bianca Wild, respectively. Hawk going to back Bianca into the ropes while Riddles socks it right to Chris Shady in the front corner. As Hawk, these two are like mimicking each other. They're almost trying to one-up each other. And it looks like the crowd is more solidly behind Riddles than they are Hawk. And that's got to be grinding on the psyche of Hawk. It seems as though these former partners are almost battling for popularity. Bianca Wild barely staying up on her feet. And now these guys are going back to shoving each other in the ring. That's a mistake on their part. Looks like a go to sleep for Riddles. No. Oh! I would have to say on that occasion, Riddles was more impressive than Hawk. Double cover, and Hawk breaks up the cover that Riddles had. We got a cover, and Riddles breaks up Hawk's cover. And now these former tag team partners are trading blows in the center of the ring. Who's going to get the advantage? Rights and lefts. Hawk takes out the legs of Riddles. Now he's on top, and I would have to say that there is definitely some leftover tension from the breakup of the Inner City Posse. Now Riddles is on top of Hawk, hammering away. I can hear those shots from here. They're rolling around and down to the floor they go. Riddles lands on top of Hawk and this battle is on the floor. Chris Shady looks like he is liking what he sees. These former tag team partners battling it out, but Bianca Wild is up on her feet. The former members of ICP continuing their battle on the floor with vicious shots back and forth, rights and lefts. Their action is getting close to the commentary table here. The action is right in front of us. These two are battling it out as Chris Shady is making a rookie mistake, in my opinion, with his back turned on Bianca Wild. Chris Shady turning his attention over here to Scotty Nova, who is wearing a neck brace from the attack. Oh, a steel chair shot by Bianca Wild. Bianca taking advantage of not only the sudden death rules of this match, but also the mistake by Chris Shady as he turned his back to focus on Scotty Nova sitting here at the commentary table. Could this be the apology it is? We get a cover, we get a count, and we get three.
Your winner, Bianca Wild.
It's a goddamn miracle. Look at him walking, talking. You look like you're ready to go here, huh?
Yeah, I'm ready to go out of space. He's looking over at Red Guy. He's looking over there.
We just witnessed a miracle, people. It's like Benny Hinn. Like, he's like, just like, the Lord has healed you. You ready for a match? This guy's shaking my hand. Tell you what, Nova, you look like you're ready to go. I'm ready to go. Pete, let's go ahead and have a match right now. The thing is, I want no DQ, no count out. I can do whatever I want. Let's have some fun.
Hey, Chris Shady with a chair shot as a no disqualifications pinfalls count anywhere match is next here on Aftermath. As President Buck pulls out the fork, anything goes here. Scotty Nova was not medically cleared to wrestle here tonight. And now he is driving the fork into the forehead of Scotty Nova. I may have taken a few pokes at Scotty Nova's intelligence before this match, but he doesn't deserve this here. He should be in the back resting as Buck DeRoss is now hammering away on the neck of Scotty Nova. The last time that I was here doing commentary and doing ring announcing, I saw Chris Shady. And Chris Shady is back here at ringside. And he's got that steel chair again. Oh, down across the back. That's exactly what I saw the last time I was here, except it was in the head of Scotty Nova. And Chris Shady stomps on the shades of Scotty Nova. This is just not fair here, but what are you going to do? It's the president of WAW. He calls the shots. He is the man that runs the ship, and Scotty Nova, whether he likes it or not, is an employee of Buck DeRoss. And as if this hadn't already started on the floor, this match is officially underway. No disqualifications and pinfalls count anywhere. I do not like Scotty Nova's chances here against President Buck DeRoss. And the neck brace comes off. That cannot... This just isn't right here. I've done some dastardly things in my time, but I don't think I've ever beat on somebody in a neck brace. Although if I have, I'm sure somebody's going to point it out to me later on. Buck on the apron. Oh! Hard boot right to the side of the head. Taking the bottom of his boot and scraping it off the forehead of Scotty Nova, and then down with a knee across the... Nova tried to brace for it. He still caught it in the neck. That's three times across the neck and the ear of Scotty Nova. But Scotty Nova is still trying to get back up to his feet. I don't know why he wouldn't just stay down here. He knows he's hurt. He knows he's in no condition to be competing here tonight. And yet he is still trying. He's got his hand on that bottom rope. And I guess if there's a will, there's a way. And for Scotty Nova, there's a will to get back up on his feet. Boom, boom, boom. Ah! Scotty Nova could, he could give up or submit anywhere he wants in this match. It's falls count anywhere. If he's in the ropes, it doesn't matter. If I was standing at ringside, as much as it would go against a lot of my managerial traits, I would tell Nova to throw in the towel here, to give it up, fight for another day. He's in the Hellbound Championship match, and I would think he wants to make it there. Oh. He's still trying to get up. Scotty Nova is still trying to get back up to his feet. Nova crawling after Buck. Buck turns around. We got a roll up. We got a cover. We get two. And Scotty Nova almost with the surprise upset win here. He's already at a severe disadvantage. Boot to the midsection. Scotty Nova trying to fight with a rolling DDT. We get a cover. We get two. And we only get two as Buck DeRoss kicks out. Scotty Nova now working over with shots in the corner on Buck DeRoss. Hit him with a couple in the stomach and then one to the back of the head. And now he's up in the corner, one shot to the back of the head. If I were Scotty Nova, I wouldn't be wasting time here in the corner because now he's paying for it. Down across the ropes, now draped over the bottom rope, still trying to fight his way back up to his feet, but the fight is starting to become less and less with every shot from the president of WAW. Nova is still fighting here. I'm really just, back chop by the president. That's a party foul because he didn't call it first. If Scotty Nova could, he could chop him back twice. Shots to the same spot on the back where Scotty Nova was just back chopped. Buck takes down Scotty Nova, rolling him onto his stomach. Scotty Nova is locked in tight. It looks like Buck is cutting off the airflow, but Scotty Nova is still trying to fight out of it. Oh, crossface. And another one. Crossface with a forearm across the jaw. Scotty Nova now, that could be a choke, but it's 100% legal here in a no disqualifications match. Nova fights out of it with an Irish whip back to the corner where there is a mysterious balloon that has sparkly lips. Irish whip hard, coming in for the DDT again. Could it be the tornado DDT? If he can hit this, this could be all, and he could get the upset win. Buck counters it, throwing Scotty Nova back out. And I think that as light of a fall as that might have been, Scotty Nova was really in no condition to even come out here and say that he wasn't medically cleared to compete. I had to do that for him. Oh, that's gotta be all. We get a cover, we get a count, we get three.
You're a winner. Buck DeRoss.
This one is versus Mr. Coleman. Buck DeRoss with the victory here on Aftermath over Scotty Nova in a match that probably should have never occurred this week. Looks like we got somebody dressed up in costume a couple weeks early before Hellbound. We will hold our annual costume contest at Hellbound. But I am receiving word right now that